Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, depending on where you are on the globe. I'm Megan Aplomb, bringing to you Fur News by the Minute, the fluff, the raw, and sometimes the rough. In this week's news, a man saves his furry neighbour in the Sunshine State. The most popular pet names are out for 2021, and we'll share tips for pet gift giving. First up, a man rushes to a pooch drowning in Florida. And you may not believe what the pup and the parent do afterward. Virtual correspondent Deborah joins us with our lead story. Deborah?
Yes, Megan. Nick Colutri was taking his parrot Yoshi out for some fresh air when he heard splashing near his home, near Chadwick Pier, Inglewood. He saw his neighbor's dog struggling to swim and unable to get back onto his father's boat. Nick grabbed his own vessel and a GoPro. Because, hey, if I'm saving someone, I'm getting famous. He eventually rescued the dog with the help of another neighbor. The dog's father was not on the boat that displays the words, "Not my problem." Okay, not my problem, really? Okay, let's hope he doesn't have kids. Soon after the incident, Nick saw the dog hanging out on the bow, alone. Although Kalitri was relieved he saved his dog, he's worried it may happen again. And let's be real, that's just happening again. Back to you, Megan.
Thank you. That, sounds like a harrowing tale. And I think the sad part is that the owner of the boat wasn't even there. Basically said, like it said on his boat, "Not my problem," right? But sir, it is your problem. Next up, Rover.com unleashes its most popular dog names of 2021. One in particular is in demand by human parents too. The pet care service platform searched its database of over 1 million users. For the male dogs, Milo came in at the fifth spot. And the top spot is Max. Mad Max comes to mind. And for bitches, the fifth spot is Zoe, and that's Z-O-E. And naturally, the first spot, or the number one spot, would be Bella. Woo, I knew a Saint Bernard named Bella. Wonder whatever came of Bella. And according to BabyCenter.com, Luna and Zoe, spelled with a Y, also made the top 50 list for two-legged baby girls. Now Liam won for the baby boys. Liam. I like that name. It's very Irish, is it not? And it's very regal-like a name. Meanwhile, Rover barked that COVID-inspired names for pets soared. Dogs named Zoom jumped nearly 450%. Fauci leaped to 270%. And the app saw its first dog customer named Doja Cat. A lot of sense that makes. Now we're joined by canine correspondent Croissant in Atlanta. She wants to share her take on the top names. Croissant was adopted during the pandemic and was previously named Pfizer. Oh, Croissant, oh, you are gorgeous. Such a gorgeous coat. You must eat a lot of antioxidants. I'm imagining berries and cabbage, red cabbage. I'm imagining perhaps that you fancy probably strawberries, because you've got a really beautiful, beautiful coat. You remind me of a Liam. Although your name is Croissant, you know what? A good croissant gets as golden as you. Not that we would cook you. I feel like I should have not gone there with you. Apologize, Croissant. But yes, I don't know where they got your name from. I'm inclined to want to apologize on behalf of your parents. Clearly, they were hungry and should have gotten something to eat before they named you. But it's much better than Pfizer, because that's an ugly reminder. Named after a pharmaceutical company. But we're happy to have your croissant, and hopefully you're as delicious as an actual croissant. Thanks for being here. Next up, pets are in even more demand during the holidays, but when is the best time to gift them? Ivanhoe Newswire published tips for potential pet givers. The article highlights parents of interest should be ready for commitment that may last around 15 years. That's 15 years worth of gift giving. Questions to be asked include, does the person travel a lot? Do they have the financial means? Does the type of dog fit their lifestyle? And who will be the primary caregiver? Many shelters report a higher number of surrenders after the holidays. Following this advice can help pets find forever homes with humans that are ready for them. I think pet gift giving is underrated. I think people don't put in a lot of thought when they do pet gift giving. They probably think that the pet will not remember or care what it is that they got and who gave it to them. And give it to them in person, I think it gives like a bigger impact when you're pet gift giving. And that's a wrap for us this morning, afternoon, or evening, depending on where you are on the globe. I'm Megan Aplomb. Be sure to sniff out the latest headlines you need to know with the Pardemic Network, brought to you by The Motley Crew. If you have feedback or story suggestions, leave a comment for us. And be sure to subscribe to the Motley Crew channel on YouTube for fur and other possum entertainment. Okay, so Zoe with the whale also made the top 50s for two-legged baby girls. All right, so we're not saying human anymore. So are we like obsolete? Is that what's going on? That's just my little tidbit when it comes to that, because I know I've given little gifts to Coco. And does Coco write or call? No. Does Coco thank me for the last gift given? No. But Coco does know that I will give Coco some little tidbits of, you know, beef nicely simmered in its own juices. So Coco remembers that, I would hope. And who do I speak to about the whole bitches thing?